Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. What is the limit of 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus until plus n factorial divided by n factorial as n goes to infinity? The concept limit is a very important and fundamental concept in calculus. How to find this limit? We are going to introduce a method called a sandwich. Here is the detail. This is the given sequence. If we rewrite the numerator as two groups, cutting from here, n factorial divided by n factorial equals 1. Then we have the remaining part. Now, if we increase each term before n minus 2 factorial by n minus 2 factorial, then we should have this inequality sign less than or equal. How many terms including this term? N minus 2. Therefore, we have n minus 2 times n minus 2 factorial. If we replace n minus 2 by n minus 1, which is a big number, then this inequality is true, less than or equal to 1 plus n minus 1 times n minus 2 factorial, then plus n minus 1 factorial divided by n factorial. What is this? This is n minus 1 factorial. We have 2 n minus 1 factorial in the numerator. What is the definition for n factorial? N factorial equals 1 times 2 times 3 times until times n. So what's the difference between n minus 1 factorial and n factorial? N factorial equals n times n minus 1 factorial. Therefore, the right-hand side equals 1 plus 2 over n. Then we have this result. 1 less than or equal to this sequence. It's obvious because the numerator is bigger than the denominator. We have n factorial here, and we have more items here. Now, here is the sandwich idea. We want to find the limit of this middle term. If we can find the limit of this lower bound and the limit of this upper bound, both are converging to a same number. Therefore, the limit of this middle term also converges to the same number. The limit of the left-hand side is 1. The limit of the right-hand side also equals 1 because the limit of the constants is the constants. The limit of 2 over n as n goes to infinity equals 0. Therefore, the right-hand side converges to 1. Here's 1, here's 1. Therefore, the limit of this midterm equals 1. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.